Hey there, folks. Welcome to another episode of PIVX Class. Today, we're going to talk about trust and how it factors into your currency. My main objective here is not to tell you who to trust or how you in particular should evaluate trust in currencies. What I want to do is get you thinking about it because many cryptocurrencies are striving to be trustless. And I realized when I decided to see what the dictionary said trustless was, it was not what crypto enthusiasts have in mind. The class should help you understand what cryptocurrencies mean by trustless and get you thinking about which ones are or are not living up to that. So without further ado, let's begin. First things first, what is the dictionary definition of trustless? Well, according to dictionary.com, trustless means not worthy of trust. Pretty simple, but cryptocurrencies kind of taken that and thrown it out the window. I suppose that would be because no one has really used the word trustless much in recent times, to my knowledge. We don't say Tom is trustless, we say, I don't trust Tom. But in the end, I can only guess to the demise of the original understanding of the word trustless. Language is a fluid thing. It evolves and grows as we use it to fit our needs. This sometimes results in these misunderstandings. But I digress. What do cryptocurrencies mean when they say that something is trustless? Simply put, it means that something does not require trust. So if you and me are making some kind of deal, a trustless system would make it so neither of us actually have to trust each other to complete it successfully and without incident. That sounds kind of unpleasant though, doesn't it? Do you really want to live in a world where no one trusts anyone else? In the end, that's a matter of perspective. You can view it as not trusting anyone, or you can separate choosing to trust someone or being forced to trust someone. If you need to trade one currency for another with someone, under traditional systems, you must trust them, or trust a third party to help you to make a fair trade. In both of those scenarios, you have to trust that either the other person or the third party isn't planning on cheating you. This is my opinion, but I believe that this actually sows the seeds of distrust. Having no alternative leads you to constantly suspecting that one day, one of these people will cheat you. Now, what if you had a system where there was no trust required? A trustless system. Say a computer program designed and reviewed by a diverse community whose only shared interest is that this program does not cheat people. Well, that system would allow you and another to trade hundreds or thousands of times without ever having any incident. You can trade without ever trusting them. Now, this does not mean you must not trust them. It just means you are not required to trust them. It also means you have no reason to distrust them. You can meet someone you've never met before for a trade and not have to question their ethics in the slightest. There is simply no way for them to cheat you in this deal. Now, if you ask me, that can be kind of a positive thing. When I find a new trading partner, I can just focus on talking to them without the shadow of doubt above our heads. Personally, I kind of like that a lot. Now, how does this fit into cryptocurrencies? A lot of cryptocurrencies use automated systems as well as consensus to verify things in a manner that takes the trust out of the equation. One of the most common examples is sending someone a payment. Fiat currencies do it pretty well, admittedly, but there are times when things get questionable and trust comes into play. You have to trust that the bank isn't doing anything underhanded or that they don't make a mistake. You also have to trust that when the other person says they did not receive a payment, that they aren't trying to get you to send it twice. In cryptocurrency, you can look at the blockchain and verify that your money went to the specified address. You can even see if that money was moved away afterwards. Furthermore, transactions are all verified by consensus, so the other person knows that you definitely did send that money and that you couldn't have canceled the send in any way. Financial privacy is also heavily dependent on trust systems. Typically, you have to trust companies to not leak or sell your financial information. To pay for their goods or services, you inevitably have to give them this information. With certain privacy-focused cryptocurrencies, there are ways of getting a payment to someone without giving them any extra information. This removes trust from the equation. This means you could buy an uncommon item online from a small retailer without worrying if they handle customer information poorly. I've personally avoided small retailers because they didn't use PayPal and I didn't want to take the chance that they would be so careless. I would be even happier if I could cut PayPal out of the equation. No offense, PayPal. This all sounds wonderful and perfect, but I do want you to take this all with a little grain of salt. Cryptocurrency is still growing, learning, and evolving. There is no cryptocurrency that is 100% trustless from the ground up, and there won't be for a really long time. Some people say it is impossible to 100% cut trust out, but if history has taught us anything, it is that nothing is impossible. But for now, it is not a reality. Currently, you have to trust the code of the cryptocurrency, the reliability of the wallet software, the nodes involved in communicating your transaction, and other aspects too. Something that helps make that trust more acceptable is that most cryptocurrencies are open source. That means you can see their code for those that understand the code. They can review it and look for exploits, problems, and scams built into the currency. Those that can't code will have to trust in the code audits of those who understand it. In all that, you can see why these trustless systems have a long way to go. But it is awesome to see how people are developing these systems into that direction. And before I wrap up this segment, I would like to point out the weaknesses in trusting fiat systems, since I just kind of hammered into crypto a bit. It can be summed up really simply. Do you know anything about the fiat system in your country? Beyond the first layer that you transact in, that is. Some of you do. Some more than me, and that's great, but many people don't. I myself do not know nearly enough, and for a long time I knew nothing. That means I was trusting a system I knew nothing about. As I learned a few things about it, I realized every aspect of it falls into trust. Who prints the money? How do they control it? How my money is secured? How is it moved? And more. I am forced into trusting everything about my fiat currency. Ultimately, what system and what currency you trust is your choice. I don't want to deliver a verdict for you to follow. I just wanted to put the question of trust in your mind and allow you to evaluate it for yourself. Cryptocurrency is not a perfect trustless system, but it is trying. What that means for you and your finances, only you can decide. So we'll leave it at that for today. As always, if you have any questions, please feel free to comment below, and I will do my best to answer them. If you found this video helpful, leave a like and consider sharing the video. It actually helps the channel out a lot. Thank you for tuning into today's class. I love having you here, and I will see you in the next PIVX class.